good afternoon, good evening and good night, and welcome to the Department of Interior Architecture and Furniture Design. Today we have in the program some videos about the project week we just did last week, and in the parts in between we have some interviews with the third and the fourth years, alumni and some head of departments as well, and afterwards a small Q&A, so stay tuned.
So to quickly introduce ourselves, we have six hosts. The four of us on camera are Sasha from Holland, Dave from Holland, Bo is me from Holland, and Jonathan from Germany. And we will quickly move on to a section about ourselves, the first year, to give you an impression on what the first year is like. Let's move on.
Exactly. So Sasha, how was it for you moving from Poland to the Netherlands to study? What did you experience?
So for me, of course, it was a quite big change moving to a different country to study. But I would say I settled in quite quickly and quite well, mainly due to the very international surrounding in school and a lot of international people in our class and our department. So I really enjoyed this process and I think it went quite well for me. But what about you guys? Because you are from Holland, and how was it for you to come to The Hague to study?
I can answer that question because personally, some people they focus on, they really want to go to KABK and then they focus entirely on getting in here. I considered other academies, but then eventually ended up still choosing KABK because of its autonomous approach, its conceptual approach compared to other academies, like the coding in Rotterdam, but yeah, I really wanted to go here.
Yeah, I also really wanted to go to the KABK specifically, but still you need to move, of course, because I was not originally from The Hague. I lived in a city close by, so I still can visit friends way more often than other fellow students. But also, like, the academy itself is also kind of a whole new bubble, so it's really this international group that
it's
you
nice
say is really,
it.
Yeah.
That was quite an easy process for all of us.
Well, there are always some hurdles, of course, and I think everyone has them. Like, for some people, well, for me, housing wasn't a big problem, but you sometimes hear it that people are still looking in the beginning, like the first semester, the first couple of weeks, because they have only for a short time a house. I think some fellow students of ours said the same thing, but they managed in the end. Luckily,
but you don't have to freak out about it because the Netherlands like that is all very like short term notice. Like there's a month before there and only the apartments are online, so you can't find a place. You don't have to freak out about it.
Yeah.
And I also heard in the introduction week that a few people were still searching, and also due to the community of the KBK, they came from they got rooms.
How was it for you? Is it like you expected to be studying at the KABK, or is there some big differences to your expectations? Like, how is it?
Well,
maybe comparing it to your previous studies and other courses.
Yeah, well, we obviously talked already a lot about this in last semester, of course, and I think we all concluded that it's like way more conceptual than we expected it to be, and I definitely agree with that, especially because I also have kind of a technical background, so for me that was maybe even more to adjust for me, but also really like, it's also kind of a mindset that's really interesting and an exploration as well.
I can also answer the question, I think, because I studied at Visual Coding, which is a very different academy in terms of atmosphere and style and the vibe they were going for, because they want to live somewhere in between this conceptual approach that we're doing and more in touch with the real world, because they have stations like vision station and textile station, but this business station where you become more in touch with what is a business practice like is way more in tune from the first year onwards than what we're doing. Some people, they really miss out on that. And with some people, they don't want to think about that because the academies work with this innovative approach. But it's interesting to know what we are doing.
And how was it for you with your with the portfolio and with the assignment? Like, how much time did you spend on it? And did you freak out, or like, how did you manage your time? Also, when did you upload? Maybe you can give us some details.
I think it was very different for everyone.
Yeah,
hearing
definitely.
How long they spent on it. Personally, I spent a few good months putting everything together and doing the assignment. So it did take me quite some time. And I did send it right before the deadline.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, definitely right before the deadline. But also, like, unlike if there is another deadline. I think there are three deadlines.
Yeah.
There are three possibilities to apply. And I did the last one as well. But that was more due to that I was doing my portfolio. I had to gap year. And before that, I already did some projects, so I could put it in there as well. And I was just really slow down, taking the time for everything and also my other life. So I wasn't as stressed about it, but in the end, yeah, it still needs to be finished a little bit, but it was fine. And I think it's more that you take in, put in the effort, and they also have these portfolio reviews that I found very, very good to have, because I had not really an idea. I don't come like from a very creative background, so saying that a lot of friends are also, now they are, of course, because I made a lot of new friends, but originally not a lot of people went to an art academy. For me, that was very helpful to have this talk with some teachers from the KABK.
Exactly. You can also find like some book, like a booklet about the portfolio on the website, and then you have those individual talks, which Doug just mentioned, where you can get really good feedback on it. And for me personally, I uploaded it for the second deadline. But it's always good to know, like, you can try to do it on the first one or the second one, but if you don't manage, you still have a third deadline. So it is really doable, and
I think that was especially for me that I wanted to have like the way I wanted it to be. So that's why I went for the third deadline, that used some more time. And some people will maybe.
And maybe talking about our experience as first years, how was the first semester for you guys? How did you find it? Going back to like what you expected, and
Maybe you can answer that.
Yeah.
Giving more general information.
Well, for me, it is like I knew before that it was going to be a lot of work, and it is a lot of work, but it's also really, especially in the first semester, for me, it was really good that we had a lot to do, because you really get to know like all the workshops. You know, we have a big wood workshop, a big metal workshop with tons of machinery, and you really get to use it all. You know, sometimes you spend like 6 hours just working on like a metal project. So that was, it is a lot to do. You really have to focus on school, and you really also, then you're done with it and you still have to deliver homework, and like every week there's assignments and stuff to deliver. But in the end, I was really, and I think everyone was really, really proud of their results. And in the end, like, we had a little like an expedition, like a collective where you presented everything. It was really great to see all what you've done in the first semester.
Yeah, because you're still working all the time. That especially at the end, you all of a sudden realize how much you did in this couple of months. And for me, that was quite overwhelming as well. Like, whoa. We just did this, not only me, but everyone. It was really nice to see also, because you're sometimes a little bit more focused on your own work, because you have to deliver, of course, with all these deadlines. But in the end, it really pays off.
Yeah.
We'll be right back.
Basically, what Jonathan said was that they were speaking about first-year experience, but this is Dan and I'm Courtney, and we are alumni. So I graduated last year, and Dan graduated a couple of years ago. And yeah, what are you up to now, Dan?
What am I up to now? I'm currently developing, like, it was a, after I graduated, it's just 3 years ago, it was quite a bumpy road. I mean, it's after you graduate, you have to really figure out, like, what we do after the academy. And but it's a nice process, and currently I'm just working on my own design studio, developing it, and I'm currently very busy with designing wallpapers and pillows, so more focused on the home interior stuff. Which is quite cool because I have a kind of nice collaborations from all over the world right now with different artists where I create different kinds of collections. So a lot of nice things are happening right now, and
Go give them a follow.
Yeah, you can follow.
In addition, do you think that in the last 2 years, or just the last year, do you think the KABK prepares you for this outside of KABK life, for the real life, or your professional career?
I think you have to be very, like, KABK is a good base after you get graduated. I think that you get a kind of open mind after you graduate here that becomes actually very strong. But, so you really have to have your own will and to develop yourself more and just try out stuff to see where you can go to. And I think it's really important to have a kind of business mindset as well, but just try to look for people that can help you if you don't have it, or just go out there and just try out stuff. I mean, what I'm doing is mostly online. Like, I'm using a lot of Instagram, for example, and it's such a wonderful world right now where a lot of people are with the same issues, and together you can become stronger.
What my advice would be during your study program is also to try and network as much as possible. So I know it's a bit difficult with COVID now, but if you are able to go to events or somewhat socialize with people, use that network, because our industry in general is based on who you know, and then using those contacts to help you further your practice after you graduate, depending on what you're actually doing.
And I think also, just to come back to the academy itself, like, KABK is of course very international, which is very big benefit because you can know a lot of different people, also from different departments. That's at least what I always liked when I was studying here, that they had, well, we are departments above the textile department, for example, and you can always drop down and talk with them, and afterwards, these people mostly stay also in The Hague, which also, like, everybody has the same issue as you do when you graduate. Like, it's nice when you graduate and some people get picked up by galleries, and some have to work a little bit harder. But it's fine. It's nice that there in The Hague there's a very artistic atmosphere hanging here where people still are willing to help you as well. That's at least what I experience. It's really, like, they're really open for you, and they're not, it doesn't really feel like, oh, this is this guy from this gallery or something. They're really nice.
And also what's nice is after you graduate, you still have a year to use the academy and the workshops and to still use the facilitators and everything to ask for their advice. And but that's just a little bit about us. And we're having a Q&A apparently at the end of the session. So that'll be a live Q&A, so we can also, the first just can try and answer those questions, but we'll be around as well. I think next up is another video from the first week.
Correct, another video from the week we just had. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Hi, I'm Sil, and now we are with two students from the third year, and we will ask them some questions about specifically about the exchange you did. Maybe you can tell us about the experience.
Because if and somebody doesn't know, in the third year you were given the opportunity to do an exchange year. I mean, you can do it in different years too, but I think it's very common to do it in the third year here. Yeah, so how was your experience of that? And tell us what you did, where you went.
Yeah, so I went to Iceland to do an exchange there, and I studied product design.
Okay.
And actually, it's quite similar than school here. It's just that you only work on one project instead of like six at the same time, which is also nice, of course. And yeah, it was just really nice to experience a different way of learning as well. And also being surrounded in this landscape of Iceland was really inspiring.
Yeah.
And it was also, I think, interesting because it's an island and there was not that many access to materials, whereas here you have access to almost everything. Like, you can also just go to the action and buy some materials that you need and experiment with, and there it was not an option. I think it's really common here to do, and it also makes you think differently about the materials that you use.
Nice. But are you happy you did it? Do you think it was a good experience?
Yeah, it was definitely a good experience, and also to because I'm a Dutch student here, so like, I know also when tutors are talking Dutch, it's maybe like the other students cannot understand it, but I think I also experienced it in Iceland, so now I also know how to do
that. So it's also a nice experience, something different, and
yeah,
have a little change in your studies.
Yeah, definitely. I would recommend it.
Yeah, that's really cool.
Yeah. And yeah, I don't know, how was maybe the application? Was it difficult, or what did you have to do first?
Yeah, so we had to send in a portfolio, and I think it was portfolio and had to write a motivation letter, but I think it was not that hard to do. Yeah, but won't be discouraged if you think like, okay, I need to do this and that, but it's really
So it sounds fun. And how was your first semester as a third year? How was it different to the second year? I don't know, depending on how many projects you have to do or how the classes look like.
I think the main difference was actually that it was more free than the second year. Now, of course, we had I think still a lot of classes, like about 5-6 classes, and we still had assignments for every class, but they were more like a framework and like a guide, and then within this frame you can actually narrow your interest down and execute it the way you wanted. Why I thought in the second year it was really more, it had more there were more just bullet points you need to, like boxes you need to check. I think it was really nice. Like, I was able to define myself more through my work, and I liked it. Also, the structure changes a bit now, which is awesome.
And what was your favorite course this past semester?
I think the field research. We went to Paris to do field research, and then we and the first block we really did only like the theoretical research on it and came up with like more information, and in the end you look back at it and designed a piece.
Okay, cool. Thank you so much for your time, and now we will go to the natural pigments video. Thank you. And we are back with the fourth-year students. This is Josh and this is Leandra. And we wanted to talk some more about your experience as fourth-year students and what you're looking forward to this year. Maybe you can start by telling us how the fourth-year is structured and what are the main projects or tasks this year.
Yeah, so the fourth-year is structured a little bit different because our schedule is more open. But basically, you start the year thinking about what you want your thesis to be in your graduation projects. But on the side, you also do what they call the applied assignments, where you worked, we worked with a client. So you have a separate project that is collaborating with outside of the KABK. And then we now this year did a project with the KB, which is the Royal Library here in Hague. And that project runs until December. And then now we are focusing solely on our thesis and graduation. Right.
Yeah.
I think that's it.
So a busy year ahead of you.
Yeah.
Maybe you can tell us a little bit about the thesis. What is it about?
Our personal thesis?
Yes.
Okay. So mine is talking about spatial disorientation that relates to our body and our habits every day. It started with my personal experience of being disoriented for knowing my existence in space. And there I started to understand what is our position in space. And to get to know the meaning of space, the concept of it instead of a literal architecture, and how we shift the paradigm of usually disorientation is known for like something like illness or something that is bad, but actually we can gain some moral value and spatial awareness with spatial disorientation.
Okay. Yeah. Very interesting. And do you guys already have any plans after you graduate? Have you started thinking about what you would like to do next?
I'm personally trying to focus on thesis and graduation
for
first.
Yeah.
I think for not a backup plan, but you can always reach your internship provider to get more connection, or maybe you already built connection while you're doing your internship. So I feel like you don't really have to worry that much right at this moment. I know Josh has already started to work with the internship provider that he did. Really focus on thesis and graduation because the deadline is
very fast. Yeah, great. And how have you been enjoying fourth year so far compared to the other years? Just because it's so different now that you have these other projects to work on.
I personally really enjoy fourth year because it's really focused on you instead of doing assignments and really.
So you can make it very personal.
Yeah, and also you can tell that you started to know your language, what is repeating throughout the studies, what's your fascination, and you can really focus on that.
Okay, great. Thank you guys.
Oh, thank you.
That was very short.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's I think from the first year till the end, you just get more and more personal with your studies and how you deal with what you do. And I think it's also very nice that you have a very open schedule. So it means you can do a lot of your own interests and work, for example.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Great. Thanks.
Same thing.
just watched a video about the hemp blog making, I suppose. You were there, I wasn't there because we also had the community day this weekend, this week, switched with the whole department from all years. I was in the Thursday group and you were on the Friday group. And it's hemp blog creation making was on the Thursday. Can you talk anything about it? Who are you, by the way?
I'm Evelina, I'm in the class with Dirk, I'm also first year. And shortly, before we go to our guests, the video was about hempcrete, which is organic concrete, so made from hemp, the plant, also known as cannabis. And you can make really strong, for example, walls with it, but also the blocks that we made, which you can use as tables. So it was very interesting.
You can also make some beautiful things with it. Heron, Mariska, could you maybe please introduce yourself before we do?
Yeah, okay.
I'm Mariska Velium. I'm a tutor and coordinator of the department. And I've been working here since almost 8 years. No, actually 8 years now. So I have seen some changes in the department, and it's always nice to see all new students coming in and also graduating. So yeah, I'm involved in sort of the coordination of all the education that we have at our department. Yeah.
And also tutor.
And a tutor, I teach in the second year a context course, and I am just about to start the classes again. And it's nice because I invite the students to actually work with the project that they've already done, so an existing work of themselves, a design or project, and to place that in an imaginary exhibition. So they choose a location, and then eventually they write a text about it. So it's not actually about the production of the exhibition, but to sort of contextualize the project in a location and write to that, and write about that to an audience. Yeah.
Okay.
It's a very continuous flow because I could first tell something about my practice. So I started architecture, when I graduated, I was working in like famous firms like OMA, and then I got really anxious about working in these kind of firms with hierarchies and with lots of competition, I think, also even in the workplace. And at the same time, I was invited to do a couple of to design a couple of events like fashion shows and also exhibition design. And that was really where my heart was opening up within the discipline. So I found, let's say, a sort of niche. And from that moment, I started to define my company, which is called Event Architecture. And I do actually a lot of temporary architecture, but it could also land in landscape. Or landscape design or buildings, etc. So it's not like defined in a scale. What I do here, I'm head of department, and with pleasure. And I inherited actually a very good working machine in 2015. And the transformation was more in the terms of, you know, we have this new liberalist society. And we want to, you know, escape that fixation on success a little bit. So first, let's say the well-defined organization was very much targeted to a successful practice. And I think now we are also, you know, catering more for personal growth, personal development next to professional development. So this is, also an ongoing process. Yeah.
So why did you choose KABK, or how did you both came?
I think because initially the interest was in me. So it was like, it's not my choice, but more that I was invited to give a lecture here, and then it sort of fitted really well.
It was like the atmosphere of the academy as well.
Yeah, okay. And also my experience, let's say, connection also to, and also a lot of educational experience.
It's very interesting that you said.
Sorry, yeah, we have to go on. A lot of people, you have a lot of questions.
Well, I really can relate to that, and that's like the biggest pity of today is that it isn't in person, because the whole building, the people here, everything has kind of a vibe that is very specific, and for me, very interesting.
All right.
We have
we're
to go
watch
to
the video.
It was at this moment that he knew he fucked up.
For example, in a day. Maybe it's interesting to explain what we have been making here, because in the last week we had a project week. You probably saw this in a video already,
This is bio-based plaster.
Specifically made from loam and some other ingredients as well.
Which is a kind of clay.
Clay is more like loam. It's a specific earth that's like a certain percentage of clay and like other dirt. And you can really do a lot with it. And in this case, we made 1,000 of it. And as you can see, the colors are, there is a wide range of possibilities with it. But what also is, that's like what we did last week. We have done a lot of other things, but I think where the viewers also really want to know is maybe a little bit more about the application. So maybe what's a good question is, where are you tutors looking for in skill sets and like, or what really springs out in like, and pops up in a portfolio that you think, oh, this is someone who can study in the KABK?
Yeah, maybe I can say a little bit about that, and also related to the question that's coming in about the shelter assignment. With the portfolio, you really, as a candidate, sort of tell a story about yourself, about your personality, about your fascinations, about your interests. And we also specifically ask for a PDF portfolio, not so much a website, because it's really a story from A to B that you can show with your portfolio. And with the shelter, it's purposefully a very open assignment, so you can choose your own interpretation, but it's always interesting if you place that shelter, if you think of a context for the shelter, so also a user for it and a skill. So it could be something that you may need for a refugee, but also a bigger dimension. So we try to sort of embed the both the disciplines, so furniture design and as well as interior design, in that assignment. So I think that's why we chose for this shelter. And also in terms of materials, it's very open, so you can really fill it in the way you want to. Yeah.
Okay. And also coming back to portfolio and there, for example, the shelter assignment, but also assignments, whatever you make, you can put it in, right?
Yeah.
And when I applied, and also maybe it was for you, because I did a preparatory year, which is a year you just do 1 year and afterwards you can apply for KABK or other academies, you're free to do whatever you want. I learned that it's very important to implement experiments. So things that you think were a mistake, they're ugly, they're weird, maybe you even think they're wrong, but what KABK told me then is to show them. So what could you say about that? What do they show, tell you, something that was not considered a success for the students?
Yeah. Well, it gives us a lot of insight on how you make your design, your decisions while designing and drawing. So it really gives us insight on the process of thinking, design thinking, and that's what we really look for when it comes to the student, potential students. Yeah, sort of thinking with their hands and of course also with words. So in a broad sense, art education is process-based education. So yeah.
I think also efficient and like really making the project your own. Like a shelter last year with the same assignment in the case of the shelter. But you really have to make it your own, create your own environment. Yeah. And if you really like it or go deep into it, then others will as well. But I think, sadly enough, we have to wrap up. Thanks for watching. Thanks for coming. Hopefully, see you next year. Hopefully as new fellow students. Good luck!